ask and ye shall receive. I've had a lot of requests for this one, so today I'm going to be discussing the movie Trucks, the red-headed stepchild of Maximum Overdrive. Well, no green goblin head truck in this one. But in this one, the ringleader truck is played by the Western star Big Boy. Takes its name and plot from the short story Trucks by Stephen King. This is, of course, the same book that Maximum Overdrive was based on. However, this movie sticks a little closer to the plot of the book. You know a movie is low budget when they can't even do the car door cliche. Much the same scenario, a bunch of people trapped in a diner being circled by a bunch of trucks driving themselves. It's not every day you watch a movie and spot somebody you actually know. Jay Brzo, who plays the old hippie, happens to be a former co-worker and good friend of my late grandmother. Very funny man. It's just too bad they didn't give him a lot to do here. Except get himself killed saving Brat Girl's life in the inevitable homage to Duel. Poor guy. Maximum Overdrive built on the events of the book by having all kinds of household appliances and even plumbing affected by the phenomenon. But this movie sticks closer to the book, and only trucks are affected, including some light-duty vehicles. Although, curiously, passenger cars are once again not affected. Okay. What? I've seen my share of killer car movies, but this takes the cake as far as originality and comedy, I guess. It's a friggin' toy. Step on it or friggin' dropkick it or something. Come on. So at one point, this guy with the IQ of a grilled cheese sandwich finds a non-running pickup in a garage and decides to fix it. Oh, here's the Oscar clip right here. Okay, boys, bring her in. Little powwow.
They're talking to each other.
What?
They're communicating.
What are they saying?
Yeah, these things actually seem able to talk to each other, which I found kind of cute. But I guess that's another of the movie's shortcomings, because there's no way they were trying for cute. Later in the movie, Big Guy actually orders two of the other trucks to stand down. They recognize that this guy here is the gas station manager and they want to feed. Speaking of which, there is one major issue with the scene where they fill the trucks. Because truck number one took out the power.
Darn.
Later, truck number two takes out the generator. Which leaves me wondering exactly how the hell the gas pumps are still working. In the end, the old geezer with the terminal illness volunteers to act as a decoy, so the others can make their getaway. Oh no, not you again. That thing's like a turd that won't flush. Yeah, it's not a great movie, but after all, it is a B-movie. And hey, it's got killer trucks in it. I mean, that's the best redeeming quality you could ask for. And I kind of like the open ending. The book ends with the narrator looking up and seeing a plane and wishing he could believe there were people in it. Ah, no cliff dive? Denied!
Just hang on, folks. I repeat, just hang on.
Son of a bitch!